Hey everybody, I am Pastor Trevor. I'm the lead pastor here at First United Methodist Church. And I just want to take just a few moments today to go as quickly as I can through just the financial health of our church. We did not do a full stewardship campaign this year, and that's because we had some really, really good, creative, productive campaigns in the last few years. And sometimes when you do that, you just need to kind of have a breather year and not have a full campaign. And so that's what we did. But I also want to provide you the opportunity to make a financial commitment to the church. And so you're going to be receiving a letter this week or next that's going to have a letter, and then it's going to have the 2023 pledge card on it. And then it's also going to have a link that if you go to our app, you should be able to see the link that you can do a digital card as well. And so we're going to ask you to have those in, if you can, by November 20th is our plan. That's the Sunday before Thanksgiving, and that's not very far away at all. And so if you don't get it to us by November 20th, get it to us hopefully by the end of the year would be really helpful for us. And so in that spirit, I just want to kind of share some facts that you might find interesting. The first is this, that we are numerically growing. We are growing in nearly every age demographic in our church. The fastest area that we are growing is our next gen ministry. Fun little factoid we've learned over the last couple months is that our average worship attendance is about 360, 370. And that's not just people involved, that's people that on any given Sunday are engaged in worship in our building. And so between our five children's Sunday school classes, they make up about 30-ish or so kids, meaning just shy of 10% of our average worship attendance is in our next gen ministry. That's really exciting. When I started here, there was only one Sunday school class, and Kyrell and Veronica and all of our Sunday school teachers and next-gen volunteers have really kind of allowed this thing to flourish in a really good, productive way. The other thing you need to know is that with that growth, we've had 30 givers start their giving journey with us at First United Methodist Church this year, which is really cool. 30 new people that weren't giving in the years before, weren't even part of our community, have started giving this year. The downside, of course, is that there's about an equal number of givers that have not or have stopped giving this year as well. And that may be because they've died, maybe because they moved away, maybe because a certain situation happened in their life that has not allowed them to continue their giving, or they've left the church, some combination of those things. And so the giving units themselves may appear pretty close to equal. The giving itself is not. And so even though we are growing numerically, financially, we are seeing a slight downturn, which can be a little concerning as well, but we'll get there. The average gift per giver in our church is $3,307. Those that are between the ages of 71 and 80 make up about 36% of all income giving at First United Methodist Church. Interestingly, about 36% of our giving comes from people 61 and under. A little food for fact. There's also 13% of you that give to our church with regularity that we don't know your age, so we don't know where to categorize that. And I just find that sort of interesting, and there's a whole bunch of stats that we could go through, but I thought I'd share it with you. And I'm making this video, I guess, to sort of be as transparent as we can about our financial health. We are not as financially healthy as we were 15, 20 years ago, 10 years ago. We are about where we were maybe 5 years ago, and maybe a slight downturn, even though, ironically, we're growing numerically. And so if you haven't started your giving journey, I'd ask you to do so, to consider what might it look like for you to start it. Maybe you start with just 10 bucks a month or something, right? Something small, something that you can do. And I think not only is it just a really good spiritual practice to engage in and not allowing your money to have so much power over you to give over some, but it's also just good practice in being in a community and financially supporting the ministries that we know and love and in this community that we really care for. So that's it. I hope you fill out the financial pledge. It helps us and our leadership team as we go into the season of budgeting for next year. And as always, anytime you have a question about the church, especially related to finances, if it's important enough for you to wonder, it should be important enough for you to ask, and we will be sure to try and get the answer to you. So don't hesitate to ask. That's it. Thank you all very much. I really appreciate it. And as always, I want to end with this. Just thank you for your continued giving and support. I know there are some people in the church that have gone through incredible, heartbreaking things this year and have continued to give throughout it. And I was shocked and blown away by that and really deeply humbled and grateful for it. So I just give thanks to all of you for you giving and for those of you that have made it to the end of this video as well. I commend you. All right. Thank you. And we'll see you later.